Hello everyone, welcome to this video, and here we'll see how we can make the crosswords and we can take the assessment of our students. We can put a crossword at the end of every topic so that we can judge how much the students have understood. This is another way of making our teaching quite interesting. For this, we'll use hot potatoes. So on your browser, just type hot potatoes. This is the home page of the hot potatoes. We need to click on this hotpot.uvic.ca. When we click on this, we need to click on this download. The latest version is hot potatoes version 7, which is freely downloadable. And when you will download your hot potatoes, you'll have something like this. So this is how the hot potatoes would look. Now, let us start making our crossword. For that, go to this icon, which is potatoes, and you can see that these are the various options that we can make using hot potatoes. We have the quiz, the close, the match, mix, cross, and mashup. For the crossword, we need to go to J cross. So, as soon as we click on this J cross, this is a grid which I can see here. Now, to start inserting the words, I need to click on Manage Grid. I'm repeating it. For starting with the words, click on this Manage Grid. Go to this Automatic Grid Maker. Now here, you can type the words that you want to be there in your crossword. So I am making a small crossword to show how it will appear. Let me type life insurance, and with each word try and write it in another line. General insurance, fire insurance, reinsurance, ULIP, term plan, endowment plan, co-insurance, and deductible. Alright, so these are the words that I have. The maximum grid size is 20. You can increase or decrease it. Now, click on this, make the grid. Now, as soon as I make the grid, you can see that this is what the hot potatoes has made for me. Now, to start giving the clues to your students, we need to click on this add clues. As soon as I click on this add clues, it would give me two options, for across and for down. So this is for the across, the general insurance, fire insurance, and this is the down, life insurance, term plan. So now we have to start the clues so that the statement what the students would read, and then they'll fill the crossword. So for that, just click on this general insurance and start typing here. Insurance where subject matter is anything other than life. So this is the first one done. After every clue, we have to click on OK. And then go to the second one and type subject matter is fire, is loss against fire. Again click on OK. Then go to endowment plan, plan with the benefit of getting the assured amount, insured amount. So like this, you can fill all the clues, right? So as soon as you fill the clues, they'll start appearing in front of the words. All right. So I'm just doing it fast. For co-insurance, risk shared between insurer and insured. Don't forget to click OK after every statement. Reinsurance, insurance between two insurance, I don't take the subject as confirmatory because I'm doing it quickly, deductible. The initial amount to be paid by the insured. So I have filled all the clues. Combination of insurance and investment. Okay, so all my clues are filled here. Now I'll go to down. Life insurance. Subject matter is life. Click on OK. And term plan is no amount is paid if there is no death. Okay, so OK. So after doing all this, when I have filled all the clues, we'll click on OK. Now my crossword is ready. To make certain adjustments, I need to click on this. Remember this? We have to go to the configuration screen. When I click on the configuration screen, I get these options. What do you want the title? So this is by default already there. So I'll use it. I'll already use it. Prompts or feedback. That is across and down. And if all are correct, then correct, well done. If some are incorrect, what will appear? And so on. All right. Buttons, you can write this also. And here, you can just remove the caption. I don't want any caption. All right. So, I'll just remove these because there is no next exercise. So, I'll remove this. I'll click on OK. And just one more thing, you can also change the timer. Okay, so if I want that it should be of 10 minutes, so I need to check this. And after that, this thing would come. Going to other, don't forget to click this. Show all clues below the crossword grid so that your crossword and all your across and down clues would appear on the same screen. It's very, very, very important. Let us go to OK now. Now, to export this, we have to export in two formats. Go to File, first, create a web page. Go to File, go to Create Web Page and Standard Format. You can just save it anywhere. I'll save it at the desktop. So, hot one, right? And let us see how it will appear. So, this is how the crossword would appear. All right, you can see that the timer has started here and these are the across and the down clues that you mentioned. As soon as the student would click here, he'll get a hint. So he can write his answer here and he can just put on enter. Okay, so this is how it will appear. This is the one format that you need to save and you have to share with the students. The other is, I'll just go back to the hot potatoes. And go to File again and go to Save As. So again, I need to save it at the desktop and I'll give it Hot One. Alright, so these are the two things that have been saved. Let us see. So this is, both these things have to be sent to the students so that they can see how the crossword appears. This is the crossword. Sent to the students. I hope you enjoyed this session. Thank you very much.